I'm feeling a little strange right now because for the first time in over a week, I will be looking into our champions booth and not seeing Alan Lesher. But let's find out who we do have in there. One of our players, Johnny.
All right, Alex, meet Kim Leach.
Hi, Kim. Very brief, tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm a native Californian from Torrance. I'm an audiovisual specialist, and I get a real kick out of acting on stage.
Okay, good luck to you on the program. Hope you wind
Thank
up
you.
Winning lots of
Thank
cash.
You.
Let's meet your opponent.
Here is Michael Cowell.
Hello, Michael.
Hi, Alex. How are you?
What kind of work do you do?
I'm an attorney.
A what?
An attorney.
An attorney. I was going to say that because you look as if you belong in a courtroom there. You've got the vest on and everything. You win most of your cases?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, I don't want to get into doing plugs for you, but I'll just wish you good luck. You know, of course, that a game is $500. You are both familiar with how we play the game, right?
I am.
So we're going to go right into it, and we'll start off, as we always do, by showing our home audience the right answer. The first subject, players, is a person. Game is $500. Here we go. Clue number one. She calls her chili con carne the Pedernales River Special. Next clue. In 1943, she bought a debt-ridden radio station and turned it into a multi-million dollar operation. And that's Michael's buzzer.
I'll take a chance at Lady Bird Johnson.
You're right. That's a good chance to take. $50 for you, Michael. And you are now in a dare situation. Let's look at the next clue together. She calls Thomas Jefferson my favorite other president. That's the dare clue. You can give it to Kim and gamble that he won't know the answer. If it works out that way, you'll have an extra $100. If he gets it, it'll be tied, 50 apiece.
I'll take the dare.
You'll take the dare? All right, let's bring Kim back. Michael's in the lead. He got a right answer, $50 in cash. He's taken the dare. You've got 5 seconds to look at this clue, Kim. Your answer, please.
Betty Ford.
You are wrong. We close you off. We give Michael $100 more. That takes him to $150. And it's double dare time, Michael. Before you make up your mind, let's look at the clue. To meet their entertaining obligation, she and her husband bought Pearl Mesta's luxurious home in Washington, D.C. That's the double dare clue, a possible extra $200 for you.
I'll take the dare.
Okay, let's bring Kim Leach back. Double dare time, Kim. He has taken it, and you've got 5 seconds to look at this clue. What is it, Kim?
Lady Bird Johnson.
You are right. Lady Bird Johnson. Almost a throwaway there for you. That means you now have $100. Michael has $250. We should take those scores back. $250 for Michael and $100 for Kim. Michael, you're leading. No, Michael should have $150. I'm sorry. I'm getting confused now. $150 for Michael and $100 for Kim. And we are going on to another subject. We got it. We'll get it organized. Meanwhile, you folks at home, take a look at the correct answer for our next subject. This time, we're looking for a thing, and the scores are now correct. 150 to 100. Here is the first clue. It costs some $30,000 a month to operate and never showed a profit. Next clue. The London Illustrated News sent a reporter all the way to St. Joe, Missouri to cover it. Third clue. Genghis Khan set up a similar system some 1,000 years earlier. Moving on to clue number four. It began operating on April 3rd, 1860 and continued for about 19 months. Remember, the subject is a thing. Clue number five. Buffalo Bill went to work for it when he was only 15 years old. Michael Cowell thinks he knows the answer.
I will take a guess in this one at the railroad. The
railroad is incorrect, so we close you off and we bring Kim back. Michael gave us the wrong answer that time, Kim, so you get a bonus. You get a look at this clue all by yourself, and we'll give you a free guess. Dime novels and Wild West shows made it glamorous. What's your answer?
No
answer? All right, Michael will never see that clue, so we'll bring him back right now, and we'll get the two of you going again for this clue. Clue number seven, it was killed by the building of transcontinental telegraph lines. Michael's back in on the buzzer.
I'm taking a chance this time in the Pony Express.
Pony Express, you are right, you're up to $200. That's twice Kim Leach's winnings. Let's look at the dare clue together. Only one of its riders was killed by Indians, though most of its route was through hostile territory. Do you want to take that?
No, I think I'll have to pass that one.
All right, let's bring Kim back. Michael got the right answer, and he's decided to pass on our dare. The dare clue was this one. Only one of its riders was killed by Indians, though most of its route was through hostile territory. Kim, do you think the Pony Express, you'd have known at that time? All right, he has $200, and you, Kim, have $100, and we have a commercial break to take, and we'll do that right now. Michael Cowell and Kim Leach are the two newcomers to Double Dare we have competing in this game. And right now, Michael is leading $200. Kim Leach has $100. We're going on to another subject, and we show you the right answer. Here we go. Clue number one. Who is this? Pope Pius XII asked if this man had children, and he replied, "No, Your Holiness, but we're having a lot of fun trying." Clue number two. 35 movie credits, mostly cameo roles. Next clue. Some of this man's detractors called him an Uncle Tom. Clue number four. He introduced scat singing. Number five. Some of his pallbearers were Frank Sinatra, Nelson Rockefeller, Duke Ellington, and Bing Crosby. Clue number six. He suffered from chronically calloused lips. And Michael buzzes in.
A guess at Louis Armstrong.
Another good guess for Michael. Michael, you seem to lack a little confidence. Every time you buzz in, you say, "Well, I'm going to take a guess. I think it might be this." Be more forceful.
Very
just chunk
enough
in there.
You tell me I'm right.
Okay, you've got $250. It's dare time for you. A chance to pick up another $100. Here is the dare clue. He starred as a sideman in King Oliver's Creole Jazz Band.
Why not? Let's do it.
Why not? All right, let's bring Kim back. Michael came up with the right answer, and he's taken the dare. You've got 5 seconds to look at this clue, Kim. Kim, your answer?
Louis Armstrong.
Louis Armstrong is right. All right, $100 separating our two players again. Let's go on to another subject, shall we? You folks, take a look at the right answer. Now, the first clue. He still remembers vividly the first movie he ever saw, Black Beauty. Clue number two. Appropriately, among his early toys were a magic lantern and a toy theater. Clue number three. In 1944, he wrote the screenplay for Torment for film director Alf Schoberg. Michael Cowell.
Ingmar Bergman.
You're right. See? You got a right answer even without saying. I'm going to take a guess on it. And you now have $300. You've got double what Kim's financial total is right now, and you're in a dare spot. Here is the clue. About his own films, he said, "A woman's world is my world. I know no other." That's the dare clue, Michael. A chance for you to go to $400 if it works.
I'll take the dare.
Let's bring Kim back. Michael got the right answer. He has taken the dare once again, and this is the clue for you, Kim. Your answer.
Orson Welles.
You're wrong. We close you off and we give Michael $100. He now has $400. And it's Double Dare time. And a chance for you, Michael, to become the new champion on the program. Here is the Double Dare clue. Government officials arrested him for tax evasion while he was rehearsing a Strindberg play. If you take the Double Dare and it works, you'll have $600. You'll be the new champ. If it doesn't work, Kim picks up $100 and he goes to $250. He would still trail you by $150. That's worth noting.
I'll take the Double Dare.
All right. Bring Kim back in. He's taking the Double Dare. 5 seconds for you, Kim. Look at this clue carefully. Your answer, Kim?
Fitzgerald.
Fitzgerald is wrong. Ingmar Bergman is the right answer. And that gives Michael the championship. Come out of there, Michael. And Kim, you're going away with $150. And our good wishes for a happy new year.
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations. Now, you got that one in good shape, you know? You feel that your performance is different when you preface your answer by saying, "I think I'm going to guess on it," or when you come right out and say it?
Well, right now I feel lucky. I may just stay with that.
You feel lucky? You may stay with that? All right. Well, you've done very nicely. You wound up with $600 in cash, and you're going to get a chance at the spoilers for a possible $5,000. But right now, though, we want to take a break for an important commercial message or two. So we'd like you folks to stay tuned. We're coming right back. He has won $600, and I'm curious, Michael, you mentioned that you were an attorney. Do you practice in courtrooms?
Yes.
Do you find usually, or can we generalize, that a delay in court proceedings is usually beneficial to your client?
It depends. If the client's in custody, no.
No? All right. Well, you're not in custody, and we're going to have to delay until our next program your shot at the spoilers for the $5,000. I hope you won't mind coming back on our next program?
Not in the least.
Okay. If it's any encouragement to you, our last champion wound up winning over $20,000 on Double Dare, and you could do that also. We'll look for you on our next program, and for you too, ladies and gentlemen. Come back and see us, won't you, on Double Dare. Have a good day.